From the east side to the west side, uptown to downtown, it's Empire Central Radio.
Friends, what is the secret soap that the most lovely Hollywood stars use to preserve daintiness? Pandora brand toilet soap, the complexion soap. Gentle white and so fragrant, it's perfect for a daily beauty bath. Leaves skin really fresh and sweet, and you feeling exquisitely clean from head to foot. Just try the Hollywood beauty bath with Pandora and you'll see why. Pandora brand soap's got that creamy, active lather that's soothing and gentle on your skin. Why, Pandora is seven ways better than old-style floating soaps. Take a tip from Hollywood. Make Pandora your daily bath soap. Pandora lathers twice as fast, even in the hardest water. It's a luxury that any woman can afford. Just a few cents a cake. Now that's thrifty. With its flower-like fragrance, it's a Hollywood secret. Ask your grocer for Pandora brand soap today.
You don't have to parlez-vous to understand the story that I'm telling you. It was a mamselle in Gay Paris. For years and years she hadn't said wee wee. When she met a handsome stevedore, she thought, what in the world am I saving it for? I want a little amour toujours. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight, by candle shine, all that's yours is gonna be mine. Was a tomato looking for a squeeze. No one had ever filled up her diaries. She said, Sherry, I've waited long. Hope it's not too late for you to do me wrong. I want a little amour toujours. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight at 8 o'clock. If you've got the key, it'll fit the lock. I had a very handsome boyfriend once, so big and so strong, but such a dunce. He treated me fair, but he was a square. He knew when, but he didn't know where. I want a little amour toujours. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight, by 9:30, you'll be putting in some overtime. Ladies like men who are big and tall, but I don't mind if you're short and small. I never measure ounce for ounce. After all, honey, it's the punch that counts. I want a little amour toujours. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight, by candle glow, my dear, I know your love will grow. I always used to dream of Charles Boyer. I hoped he'd drop in on me someday. Although you have no claim to fame, they tell me with the lights off, it's all the same. I want a little amour toujours. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. We'll be wed, you'll share my bread, and mine'll be thine, and thine'll be mine. All of the time.
It's all over, but the cry, and nobody's crying but me. Friends all over, no, I'm trying to forget about how much I care for you. It's it's all over, but the dreaming that keep trying to come true. It's all over, but the cry, and I can't get over crying over you. It's all over but the crying,
and nobody's crying but me.
Friends all over know I'm trying
to forget about how much I care for you.
It's all over but the dreaming, poor little dreams that keep trying to come true. It's all over but the crying,
and I can't get over crying.
Thank you.
WECNR Empire Central Radio. I'm Richard Foxbury with a tune that's sweeping the nation from the West Coast and back again. If you list... I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. But what's this? Well, hot off the ECNR news desk, ladies and gentlemen. We have a breaking news story involving a shooting at... Yes, it appears at the West Side Mall. Not much in the way of details here, folks. Forgive me as I go through it. It appears that the police have exchanged gunfire with unknown suspects. Arrests have been made. I repeat, arrests have been made. But all residents, for their own safety, are advised to steer clear of the area until the police have completed their investigation. We'll have more on this important story as we receive the details. I'm Richard Foxbury on Empire Central Radio, ECNR. And now, back to the music.
My darling,
I've wanted to call you my darling for many and many a day.
My darling,
I've fluttered and fled like a starling, my courage just melted away. Me, and there's not a thing I'm sane enough to say,
except my darling,
get used to that name of my darling, it's here to stay.
You are my darling, my darling. I've wanted to call you my darling
for many and many a day.
And you know, my darling,
I've fluttered and fled like a starling, my courage just melted away. And there's not a thing I'm sane enough to say,
except my darling,
get used to the name of my darling, it's here,
it's here
to stay.
Don't go away, my darling,
my darling's here.
Charlie, are you thinking of college?
No, I'm still thinking of getting out of the eighth grade.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, the trouble is with you, young man, you have no get up and go. Why don't you kindle the flame of ambition?
I'm sorry, Bergen, the pilot light's out. I wish I was out of school. That's what I wish. I wish I had $1 million to it.
That's a silly wish.
With things so high, I better make it $2 million.
Yeah. Say, that's a pretty girl dressed in that nurse's aide uniform. Do you know who she looks like?
Yeah. Why, you're right, Bergen. It's Jane Wyman. Yoo-hoo, Miss Wyman.
Hello, Edgar. Hello, Charlie.
Jane, what are you doing here?
Helping out as a nurse's aide.
Oh, well, roll up a bandage and tell us about it. Oh, you'd make a beautiful Florence Nightingale.
Would you like to have me around when you're sick?
Yeah. I wouldn't mind having you around when I'm well, either.
Charlie, if you were my patient, yeah, I'd watch over you like a baby.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. What do you say to that?
Goo goo.
Hello, Charlie and Edgar. What are you blighters babbling about?
We're talking to Jane Wyman.
Oh, how do you do, Miss Wyman? I see the most wizard thing just happened to me. It's just too wonderful.
Yeah, well, what are you so smug about?
Charlie. Look, I found this bottle.
A bottle?
Yeah, of course, there's no label on it, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's Napoleon brandy.
Yeah, well, you'd better be a little careful, you know. In a hospital, it might be a bottle of ether.
Well, let's open it up and take a sniff.
Boy, another minute and it would open itself. What'd you like?
Smells like vodka. What do you think, Miss Wyman?
Smells like fingernail polish.
Yeah, now it's my turn. Well, I still say that's ether.
Ether? Let me take a whiff of that stuff. Here I come, dreamland.
That's enough, Charlie, that's enough.
That stuff makes me feel so dizzy, whizzy.
Let me smell it again. I still say it's nangerpale polish.
I don't agree with you. I think it smells a little like a suction foda.
Give me another whiff of that, will you? Oh, Mr. Noble, I never knew you had two heads.
Oh, yes, old man. I always carry a spare.
Ooh, I'm so sleepy.
Let me take another whiff.
Let's all sniff.
Yeah. I still say it's Bransky.
Calling Dr. Pinkham. Dr. Pinkham, report to surgery. The sink is stopped out.
Where am I?
You're in a hospital.
In a hospital? Let me out of here.
But I'm your nurse.
Keep me in here.
How'd I get in the hospital?
Don't you know?
Now, don't tell me the start brought me.
Here comes your doctor.
Don't know why all my patients seem to die stormy weather. Bend me my little Wiener Schnitzel. Are you the patient?
Well, I'm not the bedpost.
You could have fooled me.
Yeah, well, who are you?
I am Dr. Streptococcus von Anderschlang. M.D., C.O.D.
And to you.
Tell me, nurse, is the patient making any progress?
Well, not with me, he isn't.
Well, I take a look at the shaft. Gallant Joe closed fast in the stretch, but he was no match for me. Oh, wrong shot.
<Yeah. laughs> What do you think's wrong with him, Doctor?
I don't know. I give him a thorough examination. Let me see. So.
What's up, Doc?
You have got hardening of the art galleries.
What?
Complicated by lumbar fandango and delicious anemia.
Here.
What would you suggest we do, Doctor?
Well, we might as well operate. What have we got to lose?
Yeah, just me, that's all.
Now, Charlie, don't you worry. He won't cut very deep.
It doesn't make any difference how thin you slice it. It's still McCarthy.
Dr. von Anderschlung, is it a serious operation?
My dear girl, all my operations are serious. Yeah, don't you think you'd better boil the instrument?
Oh, let's fry him for a change.
Oh, pardon me. What are you doing, Doctor?
I am about to operate.
Oh, how jolly. May I cut in?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yes, please do. Grab a scalpel. I'm glad you dropped in. Maybe you can help me correct my slice.
Doctors, do you know what this patient is suffering from?
Well, if you ask me, I think it's wrong diagnosis and floating dialects.
How do you operate, Doctor?
Strictly cash in advance.
Dr. von Anderschlung wanted. Dr. von Anderschlung wanted in St. Louis, Chicago, New York. Reward.
I'm a very popular fellow.
Doctor, why do you have to operate at all on this boy?
Why, he can't live 5 minutes unless we operate. What's that?
That's lunch.
I see you after lunch, kid.
Hey, wait a minute. What's the idea?
Charlie, the folks here today were very nice to us, weren't they?
Yeah, they were really super. And so was Jane Wyman.
Yes. Do you know who's going to be with us next week?
Well,
Russell. Richard Widmark. You know, the fellow who played that menacing gangster in the motion picture Kiss of Death.
Wow. I better start raising an extra crop of goose pimples. Hey, good night, folks.
Our heart has led pains in my head. Feel like old Ned. Hey, what did I do to be so black and blue? No joys for me, no company. Even the mouse seems to run from my house. And all my life through I've been black and blue. Hey, now I am white way down deep inside, but baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn. Life is a thorn. Oh, why was I born? What did I do to be so black and blue? But baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face. Lordy, listen to me, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn. Life is a thorn. Oh, why was I born? Hey, what did I do to be so black?
Empire Central Radio, ECNR. This is where the crooners hang their hats.
We go to Washington now with national news from American Century Broadcasting.
Calling the House Un-American Activities Committee to order, Chairman J. Parnell Thomas of New Jersey opens an inquiry into possible communist penetration of the Hollywood film industry. The committee is seeking to determine if Red Party members have reached the screen with subversive propaganda. Mr. Thomas takes an impartial stand in his opening talk.
I want to emphasize at the outset of these hearings that the fact that the Committee on Un-American Activities is investigating alleged communist influence and infiltration in the moving picture industry must not be considered or interpreted as an attack on the industry itself. Nor should our investigation be interpreted as an attack on the majority of persons associated with this great industry. I have every confidence that the vast majority of movie workers are patriotic and loyal Americans.
A long list of prominent motion picture witnesses appear before the committee. Speaking for the films, Eric Johnston, president of the Motion Picture Association, talks frankly concerning the attitude of the producers.
We're accused of having communists and communist sympathizers in our employ. Undoubtedly, there are such persons in Hollywood, as you will find elsewhere in America. But we neither shield nor defend them. We want them exposed. We're not responsible for the political or economic ideas of any individual, but we are responsible for what goes on the screen. We guard that with great care. If communists have attempted to inject their propaganda into the motion picture, they have failed miserably. We will never permit them to succeed.
Yeah. on the mountain, mad as I can be, looking for that cat that stole my baby from me, singing, hey, my bebop.
With plenty of room for groceries galore. The Auto Magic Permafreeze, with a super duper store automatic door. Just press the button for your ice, a feature that is new, and extra space all over the place for other items too. In the Auto Magic Permafreeze, so see your dealer right away. Get a Permafreeze today.
From the east side to the west side, uptown to downtown, it's Empire Central Radio. ECNR, your radio station for the music you want and the news you need.
Like old times, having you to talk with.
And it's still a thrill just to have my arms around you.
Still the thrill that it was the day I found you.
Seems like old. Dinner dates and flowers, seems like old times. Staying up for hours,
making dreams come true, doing things we used to do.
Seems like old times, being here with.
Gentlemen, let's go out to Jack Benny's home in Beverly Hills, where we find Rochester tidying up Jack's den.
Say, here's something the boss must have mislaid. It's a letter from the doctor who examined him, and it isn't open. I better take it to him.
But, Jack,
John, without you, life isn't worth living.
Say, Mr. Benny, I found...
Quiet, Rochester, I'm listening.
John, how can you walk out on me after all we've been to each other?
I'm sorry, Agnes, but marriage isn't for us. It just wouldn't work.
It serves me right. I should have listened to my father.
Your father. If he kept his nose out of it, things might have been different.
Oh, they would, eh? Well, if I never see your face again, it will be all right with me. Goodbye.
That suits me fine. Goodbye.
Gee, this party line is better than a radio. No commercials. Hey, what do you want, Rochester? Quiet, Polly. What is it, Rochester?
I found this letter from your doctor. It says, the results of your examination show the following. Your blood pressure is normal, your heart is perfect, your lungs clear, your blood count average, and you're in perfect condition. The doctor must have sent you this by mistake.
Nonsense, Rochester. I feel wonderful. There's no mistake. Read on.
You're in perfect condition. I want to congratulate you and hope it's a boy.
What? Rochester, let me see that report. You see? There, it was sent to the wrong address.
Phew.
Rochester, stop holding my hand. I'm all right. I'll get it. Well, hello, Mary.
Hello, Jack.
Gee, Mary, it's good to see you again. Everybody missed you last week.
Well, it was nice of you to let me go back to Plainfield for Mama Papa's 40th anniversary.
Anniversary.
Hello, Polly.
Well, hello you.
Poor Polly, she doesn't know she's a girl. How was the anniversary party, Mary?
Well, Jack, it was such a gay party. Somebody sneaked in and spiked the punch with bourbon.
No kidding. You know who did it?
Yeah, Papa. Oh. And, Jack, you should have been there to see my sister, Babe. She's very fashionable now. She's got that new look.
Shame she's got those old parts. Mary, what are you doing?
I'm reading this letter from your doctor.
Oh, that. It was just...
Why, Jack, so that's why you couldn't go to Claudette's party.
That letter was sent here by mistake. Rochester, answer the door, will you please? I still can't understand what happened last week, Mary. Ronald Coleman called me, invited me over to his house for a costume party. When I got there was no party at all.
Something wrong, Mr. Benny?
No, Dennis. It's nothing that would interest you.
Hello, Mary.
Hello, Dennis. You want to see me?
Uh-huh. You know, I sure missed you, Mary. I thought about you every single day while you were gone.
Really?
Yeah, you went off with the keys to my car.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dennis. I have them in my purse.
Dennis, stop reading that letter. It's from my doctor.
Why are you keeping it a secret? You should be very happy.
Dennis, don't be silly. That's a mistake.
But the letter says...
I don't care what the letter says. It's impossible.
Oh, yeah, you're not even married.
Yeah, I'm glad you figured it out.
Say, Jack, are we going to rehearse the program this afternoon like we always do?
No, Mary, I put it off till tomorrow. I have to go down to the Motor Vehicle Bureau and have my driver's license renewed. It expired over a month ago. You know, when I go to a bar, they always ask me if I'm over 21, you know? Anyway, Dennis, we'll have our rehearsal tomorrow. Your voice is better than ever. I suppose you'd be another Edward G. Robinson or a Ronald Coleman.
It was awfully nice of you to say that, old fellow.
Look, stop with those silly imitations, Dennis. You don't sound like Coleman at all.
Well, you thought so last week when I called and invited you to a party.
What? You were the one that called me and disguised your voice like Ronald Coleman? Dennis, answer me. Answer me!
Jack, take your foot out of his mouth.
Dennis, how could you do a thing like that to me? Now I realize what a fool I made of myself last week. I don't blame Ronnie for being mad at me. I better call him up and apologize. What a foolish thing that is.
The Ronald Coleman residence?
Hello, is Mr. Coleman there?
Who shall I say is calling?
Jack Benny.
One moment, please.
You know, I feel better already. I mean, I'll explain everything to Ronnie. He'll understand. We'll be friends again. After all, we do have so much...
Hello?
Hello, Ronnie?
This is the butler again, sir.
Well, did you tell Mr. Coleman that I'm on the phone?
Yes, sir, and it's the first time he ever hit me.
Hit you? What's come over him?
I don't know, sir, but when I mentioned your name, he screamed, "Jack Benny, Jack Benny." And then he mumbled something about dropping dead.
Well, never mind. I'll just write a note and stick it in his laundry bundle. Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
What happened, Jack?
Nothing. Ronnie wasn't in. Dennis, I can't get over it. How in the world could you think of pulling a trick like that?
Well, I don't want to take all the credit, Mr. Benny. Phil Harris helped me think of it.
What?
In fact, it was his idea.
Let me ask that phone again. I'll fix it. Imagine two guys getting together.
Phil Harris has read his residence. Elginog, the butler speaking.
Butler? Phil has a butler.
Why not? He's got two shows, you know.
I know. Let me talk to Mr. Harris.
Okay. Keep your shirt on.
Some butler. What I'm going to tell Phil is plenty.
Mr. Harris, social secretary speaking.
A butler and a social secretary. Having two shows certainly gone to his head. Put Mr. Harris on the phone, please.
Just a minute. I'll stop fanning him.
Tell Mr. Harris I want to talk to him.
Okay. Hey, Maharaja, get up off that Persian rug. You want it on the phone.
Okay. Alice, you can take off that veil and stop dancing. You like a guy like that.
Hello?
Phil, this is Jack.
Oh, hiya, Jackson. What kind of a vitamin pill is holding you up today?
Never mind. That is something I want to talk to you about.
What is it?
Phil, did you put Dennis up to playing that trick on me last week?
Oh, you found out about it, huh? Pretty good, eh, Jackson?
Pretty good. Let me tell you something.
I knew the way we did it, you'd appreciate the humor behind it.
Look, Phil.
You're the kind of a man who can recognize the basic fundamentals of satirical comedy.
I am?
Sir, that's why the name Jack Benny is regarded by millions of people as the ultimate in the field of entertainment.
Well, I certainly appreciate it.
That's okay. Goodbye, Jackson.
Goodbye, Phil. Oh, Phil! Phil, I got the most wonderful news to... Oh, I keep forgetting that letter was sent here by mistake. Goodbye, Phil. Now, come on with me, Mary. I got to go downtown and get my driver's license. Hey, here comes Don Wilson.
I hope I'm not late for rehearsal, Jack.
Oh, Don, I should have called you. We're not rehearsing until tomorrow because I have to go and get my driver's license renewed.
Well, Jack, this whole thing only takes a minute, and we might as well rehearse the commercial while I have the quartet here.
Oh, the sportsmen, where are they?
Right behind me.
Oh. Hello, fellas. You know, boys, you shouldn't always be walking behind Don. I mean, you're getting pale. You need a little sunshine. Look, Don, I'm really in a hurry. Come on, Mary, I gotta get downtown. Here it is, Mary, Department of Motor Vehicles. Oh, here's the girl over here taking applications.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes. I came here about my driver's license.
My, how'd you ever think of this place?
Well, you were recommended by some pedestrian, you see. This is one of the places they told me to go. Now, miss, my license is expired and I want to get a new one.
All right. Your name?
Jack Benny.
Name, Jack Benny. Sex, male.
Yeah, but they had him worried this morning.
Mary.
What's your height?
5'10".
Weight?
157.
Hair?
$1.98.
She doesn't mean that. She means the color. Miss, my hair is sort of a palomino gray.
Oh, yes. I noticed you're wearing a side saddle. Your eyes?
A lazy lagoon blue.
All right. Take this application and get in line at window 3 for your eye test.
Thank you. Come on, Mary. I got to go to window 3.
Yes, sir. Right over here. Your name.
Thank you. This is where I take my eye test, isn't it?
Yes. Now, can you read the third line on that chart?
Not very well without my glasses.
Can you read the second line?
Oh, yes. It says...
Would you mind taking a step back?
Not at all. Why?
You're supposed to be at least 1 foot away from the chart.
Oh, yes. Now, what do I do next?
You have to take your road test. Go right through that door to the street.
Thank you. Come on, Mary.
Who takes the next driving test?
I do. Mary, will you wait here? I'll be back in a minute.
Follow me.
I hope I won't be nervous. I haven't driven in an awfully long time. This is my car right here.
Now, before we start, I want to find out how much you know about a car.
Yes, sir.
Now, where's your gasoline tank?
In the rear.
Your gauge?
38.
What?
Oh, I thought you said my age. The gauge is on the dashboard.
All right, Mr. Benny. Start the car.
Yes, sir. The motor must be cold.
Shall I crawl underneath and light a can of Sterno?
No, I'll try it again. Well, we're running along smoothly now. Is there anything in particular you'd like me to do?
Yes, get off the sidewalk.
Oh, pardon me. We're okay now. And I want you to know that I can really drive better than this, but I'm a little nervous with an inspector in the car.
I understand. Now try and keep your mind on your driving, Mr. Benny.
I will.
See that big truck in front of you?
Which one?
That one. You can take your head out of the windshield now.
Look, Inspector, I can explain the whole thing. It's just that I was...
What's the matter with you? Can't you see where you're going, you dumb ox?
What?
You heard me. I got a good notion to haul off.
Beat him, driver!
Yeah, slug him!
Wait a minute, driver. We ought to be ashamed of ourselves. Standing here arguing when on our feet lies a poor little dog. Come here, puppy. Up into my arms. Were you hurt bad?
He's a nice guy.
Yeah. Anybody that loves dogs is okay with me.
Poor little puppy.
Hey, you know, Bud, you really are a nice guy. I had you all wrong. I'm sorry I flew off the handle.
Oh, it's all right.
I'll see that my insurance company fixes up your car.
Thanks. Come on. Come on, puppy. Let's go home now.
Jack, I just heard a crash. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. Come on, let's get out of here.
Okay, but I thought maybe... Jack, what's that you've got cuddled up in your arms?
My toupee. Come on. Let's get out of here. Come on, let's get out.
Hey, wait, Barb. Wait a minute. Boy, do I need a break.
Oh, okay, Jerry. How about a big break cigarette while we rest?
Oh, that sounds great. Now that's a break.
Great. Now, race you to the soda shop.
Hey, wait for me.
When you need to take a break from it all, reach for Big Break cigarettes.
Hi, I'm Perry Schoon from Schoon & Sons Grocers. You know, I've been in the grocery business for over 35 years now, and soon I'll be handing over the reins to my sons, Perry Jr. and Gunther. The Schoon family wants you to know that even now when times are lean, we strive to maintain the best selection of groceries for you and your family. So for all your grocery needs, come to Schoon & Sons Grocers.
Yeah.
desire. We'll sip a little glass of wine. I'll gaze into your eyes divine. I'll feel the touch of your lips pressing on mine.
The song begins, you speak, and I hear violins. It's magic. The stars desert the skies and rush to nestle in your eyes. It's magic. Without a golden wand or mystic charms, fantastic things begin when I am in your arms. When we walk hand in hand, the world becomes a wonderland. It's magic. How else can I explain those rainbows when there is no rain? It's magic. Why do I tell myself these things that happen are all really true? When in my heart I know the magic is my love for you. Why do I tell myself these things that happen are all really true? When in my heart I know the magic is my love for you.
ECNR, your radio station for the music you want and the news you need. Empire Central Radio, ECNR. ECNR, your radio station for the music you want and the news you need.
Let's take a quick intermission for news.
card at St. Helena's Gym in the Bronx tonight. Golden Gloves Boxing. First round bouts in the sub-novice lightweight class, and it's strictly standing room only. Matteo Strapone takes the measure of Tony Perillo. For the time being, that is. Tony gets in a lick or two and seems to be able to absorb all that Matteo can dish out, which is plenty. But you can't tell about these amateurs. It's nip and tuck, hit or miss. And now it's Tony who finally gets a glove at Matteo's ribs, and that leads to trouble for both fighters. They come and at it they go again, but it's about all over for Matteo Strapone. Next, we have Tony Marino and Harold Torrance. Same class, same vim and vigor. The youngster was game, but he was up against a couple of fists that packed a discouraging wallop, and the ref says, that's all.
ECNR, all night, every night.
The boy, I know it's stupid to be mad about the boy. I'm so ashamed of it, but must admit the sleepless nights I've had about the boy. On the silver screen melts my foolish heart in every single scene. Although I'm quite aware that here and there are traces of the cat about the boy. Lord knows I'm not a fool. Lord knows I'm not a schoolgirl in the flurry of her first hair. Will it ever cloy this odd diversity of misery and joy? I'm feeling quite insane and young again, and all because I'm mad about the boy. Mad about the boy.
Empty bed springs our heart as lead. Pains in my head feel like old Ned. Hey, what did I do to be so black and blue? No joys for me, no company. Even the mouse seems to run from my house. And all my life through I've been black and blue. Hey, now I am white way down deep inside, but baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn, life is a thorn. Oh, why was I born? What did I do to be so black and blue? Thank you. side, but baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face. Lordy, listen to me, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn, life is a thorn. Oh, why was I born? Hey, what did I do to be so black and blue?
The song begins, you speak, and I hear violins. It's magic. The stars desert the skies and rush to nestle in your eyes. It's magic. Without a golden wand or mystic charms, fantastic things begin when I am in your arms. When we walk hand in hand, the world becomes a wonderland. It's magic. How else can I explain those rainbows when there is no rain? It's magic. Why do I tell myself These things that happen are all really true. When in my heart I know the magic is my love for you. Why do I tell myself these things that happen are all really true? When in my heart I know the magic is my love for you.
Join Empire Central Radio tonight at midnight for the All Request Marathon. Your favorite song requests for 2 hours. Hosted by our good friend, Tim Tolliver. Only on ECNR. ECNR, Empire Central Radio, with another smooth, velvety tune. Kind of like the taste of Big Break cigarettes. You know, as I sit here having a cigarette myself here in the studio, I believe that whether you're a fan of the rich taste of a red, the lighter flavor of a white, or that smooth finish of an old blue, no tobacco company gives you more choices than Big Break cigarettes. Why, they're pretty much the ECNR of cigarettes, as we get into another great song from our vast library on Empire Central Radio.
From Hollywood, it's Dream Time. Ladies and gentlemen, the makers of Dream Shampoo are pleased to present the fifth in a series of new programs written by Phil Rapp, produced by Carlton Alsop, and starring Don Ameche.
Boy, ain't you let me sleep, will you?
Danny Thomas.
Just let him try and put me out of this phone booth, that's all.
And Francis Langford. And now Don Ameche and Francis Langford as John and Blanche Bickerson with Danny Thomas as Brother Amos in The Honeymoon Is Over. The Bickersons have retired. As usual, Mrs. Bickerson tosses restlessly, while her husband, John, insomniac extraordinary, presents this audible testimony of his constant wakefulness. Listen.
For the love of heaven, what is he doing? John! John! What's the matter with you? You're making the most frightful noises. What's the matter?
What's the matter, Blanche?
Are you in pain?
I got a terrible headache. Haven't slept a wink.
You've been sleeping like a failed ox.
Shh. Headaches.
You wouldn't have such a headache if you didn't take so many cocktails before dinner. Why do you do that, John?
Always, always do it.
Why?
No good to eat on an empty stomach. Put out the lights, Blanche.
The lights are out. But how would you know anyway with that sleep shade on?
Well, something's flashing in my head. Oh.
Take an aspirin.
Okay. I feel better already.
How can you chew those things like that? Wash it down with something.
All right.
John Bickerson, you washed it down with bourbon.
You lied to me. You got the lights on.
Yes, I'm going to keep them on. Sit up. I want to talk to you.
Please, Blanche. I can't sit up. My head will fall off. Why do you always have to talk in the middle of the night?
When else can I talk to you? You come home for dinner and bury your head in the paper, never a word out of you, and you tell me you have to go to bed early because you have insomnia.
Well, I have. Takes me hours to fall asleep.
It took you all of 30 seconds tonight.
Well, this was a good night. Good night.
John. John. I went over to see the Marvin's new baby this afternoon. It's a beautiful child. Do you know their first one is over a year old?
I hope so.
He's been walking since he was 8 months.
He must be awful tired. I am, too.
Children are such a blessing. It's wonderful to watch them grow up. You'd be surprised how many childless couples are adopting children.
I better have another aspirin. Boy, well, I got a headache.
John. Hmm? Don't you miss the patter of tiny feet around the house?
No, I don't, Blanche. Children are wonderful, all right, but you have to be able to afford them. All this talk of adopting... of adopting... What the devil is that?
What's what?
That. Put the lights on.
John.
Blanche, don't tell me that you went out and...
It's only a dog, silly. I got a little puppy.
A dog? What do we need dogs for? Where's the aspirin? Why did you get a dog
now
for?
Now, don't get hysterical.
Where is that little beast? I can hear it, but I can't see it.
He's right there in the bureau. I've got him in your shirt drawer.
You put him in there with my shirt?
He won't suffocate. The drawer's open.
Blanche, you know I'm allergic to dog hair. Gives me sinus trouble. Where's the aspirin?
You're just a big hypochondriac. You imagine those allergies like you do your insomnia.
I tell you, I'm allergic to dogs. They make me... You see? Get rid of that thing. He'll whine all night and keep me awake.
The man said he'll keep quiet if you give him one of those worm pills.
Well, where are they?
On the night table by your bed.
How do you give a dog... Where?
They're on the night table by your bed.
There's nothing here except the aspirins.
The aspirins are in the medicine cabinet.
Well, how can they be in the... Blanche, what have I been eating? No wonder my headache won't go away. Why do you do these things to me? Send for a doctor.
Don't once. Carry on so. If they're good for a dog, they won't hurt you. Go to sleep.
Go to sleep, she tells me. Here I am dying from dog poisoning. My head is splitting. And she knows I'm allergic to dogs. Hides the aspirin and makes... Ah, shut up! I don't know. I get up so early. Never get another wink of sleep as long as...
John. Gesundheit.
Thanks.
I can see how much sleep I'm going to get tonight. We'll have to get rid of the puppy.
Well, now you're talking.
I want you to take him down to the dog pound.
Okay, I'll do it on my way to work.
You go in the opposite direction.
Well, I'll go out of my way.
You say it, but you won't do it. You'd better take him now.
What?
Go on, get up. Take the puppy to the dog pound.
Blanche, are you out of your mind? It's after 2 a.m.
They're open all night. Go on, get up and take him.
Why, I never heard of such a thing. You know, I went to bed with a splitting headache, and I had to take 12 worm pills to fall asleep.
You take the dog to the pound quick enough if Gloria Gooseby asked you to.
How do you always manage to work the conversation around to Gloria Gooseby? Shut up!
Well, if you wouldn't shout so much, maybe the puppy would be able to sleep.
What's the use? Good night.
I thought it would be nice to have a little dog, especially when we move into our new apartment.
Still have a year to go on this one.
Our lease expired Friday.
I renewed it yesterday.
I canceled it this morning. Amos is raffling off the apartment for me.
That's a good idea. Amos is what?
Amos sold 500 tickets at $2 apiece, and the winner moves into our apartment tomorrow.
Oh, Blanche, no. No, I don't believe it. We'll be on the street.
Amos said he'll find us a new place in a jiffy.
Jiffy? Haven't you heard there's a housing shortage? Where will he find a place?
Well, I bought a ticket myself. It's a wonderful chance. Lovely 3-room apartment, large kitchen, big closets. It's worth $2, and we might get it.
Get it? We got it now!
I know, but even if we don't win, we get the $1,000 Amos collected for the rest of the tickets.
Look, Blanche, I gave the landlord a $1,200 bonus to renew the lease, so now I'm out $200 and I got no place to live.
Sounds like pretty poor business to me. Why do you make such deals?
Now, look, Blanche.
The trouble with you, John, is that you're too conservative.
Look, Blanche.
If you think up some of the deals that Amos has, we might be able to live as nicely as he does.
Blanche.
He's been living at the Biltmore Hotel for a year.
He sleeps on a billiard table. Look out, where's my slippers?
What are you going to do?
Let me get to that phone. I'll shoot. Down. Put on the lights.
The lights are on. Open your eyes.
Oh, there's the phone. I know it's going to ring, and I want to be ready when it does. Hello.
Excuse me.
I'm dead. Wait a minute. That wasn't Amos. Who? I'll get it. Amos.
Hi, Jocko. What are you doing up this time of night?
Packing, Amos. We're moving. Haven't you heard?
Well, aren't you going to invite me in? I'd like to look the place over.
You mean?
Yep. I won the raffle. Finest luck I ever saw.
Who drew the ticket, Amos?
Fair and square. I wouldn't take a chance having some phony draw it, so I drew it myself.
What a coincidence.
Get out of here!
What's the matter with you, Jocko? You got $1,000 coming, and if you're worried about a place to live, I'll rent you the garage. You haven't got a car anymore.
Get out of here before I hit you with a cleaver.
Okay, Jocko, you don't have to get sore.
And you better give the money back to the people you sold tickets to, or you'll have a lot of explaining to do.
Not me, brother. You'll have to do the explaining. I'll tell them you won. Good night, Jocko.
That guy'll wind up on a chain gang as sure
as... Was it Amos? Who won?
I did. Now, at last, I can go to sleep in my own bed without worrying.
No, you can't, dear. The dog's in there.
Nuts. I'll sleep in the garage.
Ladies, there's still a worldwide shortage of fats and oils that you can help with by saving every drop of your kitchen fats every mealtime. Now, that's the way to help get more soap, more fabrics, and other peacetime products sooner. So save those fats. The need is urgent, the reason sound, and dealers now pay more per pound.
We apologize for interrupting the music, folks, but we at ECNR have an important breaking news item. We are getting reports of a large-scale shootout at a Sand Island liquor distillery. Further information is unavailable at this time, ladies and gentlemen, as police cannot examine the scene due to the large fire that has consumed much of the building. More information as it comes on ECNR. And now, back to the music.
Oodle baby, ba ba, boo 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 baby, beer ya bye, boo baby. Ba 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 boo baby, ba ba boo baby, ba ba boo baby, ba ba boo ba. Ba 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 boo baby, ba be ba boo boo be ba, boo ba, be ba. Hey, now, just because my hair is curly, just because my teeth are pearly, just because I always wear a smile, I like to dress it, babe, right in the latest style. Hey, cause I'm glad I'm living. Always greet my trouble with a great big smile. Just cause I'm always handy, always feeling fine and dandy. That is why they call me Shine. Shine, wear your bluesies, why don't you shine? Start with your shoesies, say now. Shine each place up, make it look like new. Why don't you shine your face up, babe? Won't she wear a little smile or two? Hey, shine, 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 your these and thoseies. Everything's gonna turn out right fine, mighty fine.
This Friday night, don't forget to tune in at 9 o'clock for the Jackie Skorner Mystery Hour, featuring the Jackie Skorner actors, bringing you all the hair-raising radio excitement and intense dramatic action you've come to expect. This Friday, tune in as a mysterious man on a train meets up with a gorgeous Moll, and murder is the only destination. All of this and more this Friday night, only on ECNR. And there's another terrific piece of music for you, folks. I'm Richard Foxberry for ECNR with some more wonderful music on the way that's almost as sweet as Swift Lemonade. Why, it's the only beverage I reach for when I need a lift after a long, stressful day here at the radio station. There's more music coming to you right now here on Empire Central Radio, ECNR. Empire Central Radio, ECNR. The only place to find today's biggest, most popular tunes. And I'll tell you, folks, they sound even better when you listen to us on an RCO5 radio. I highly recommend that those of you who can spare the money pick one up for yourself today. I guarantee you won't find a better radio at a better price than the RCO5 from Empire Electronics. So put your hand on the dial and turn that RCO5 up now for this one on ECNR.
Town. seems like old times. Having you to talk with,
and it's still a thrill just to have my arms around you.
Still the thrill that it was the day I found you seems like old times. Dinner dates and flowers seems like old times. Staying up for hours,
making dreams come true, doing things we used to do,
seems like old times. Being
Wilson?
Oh, nothing, Darren. I'm just a little tired from hauling all these milk bottles, that's all.
Well, you know what you need then?
What's that, Darren?
A nice, refreshing Swift Cola. Here you go.
Ah, boy, that's refreshing. I better get going now. I've got a lot more milk to deliver today, and now I've got the energy to do it.
Yes, that's right, Mr. Wilson. Thanks to Swift Cola. When you need a lift, you need a Swift.
Morning, honey. Did you sleep okay?
I feel like I'm still asleep. Is that what I think it is?
It sure is. Montesino coffee. Nothing but the best for you, sweetie. With Montesino coffee, you'll be up and running lickety-split.
Dark roasted fresh Colombian beans. I love my Montesino.
Make your morning a Montesino morning.
Hey, Tommy, can I bum a smoke?
Sure. Here, have a Big Break cigarette.
All right. Wow, these Big Break whites sure are light. Thanks a bunch.
No problem, Marty.
No problem is right. Not with these Big Break whites.
Big Break filter cigarettes. Rich reds, light whites, and smooth blues. Take a break from it all.
You don't have to parlez-vous to understand the story that I'm telling you. It was a mamselle in Gay Paris. For years and years she hadn't said wee-wee. When she met a handsome stevedore, she thought, what in the world am I saving it for? I want a little amour toujours. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight, by candle shine, all that's yours is gonna be mine. She was a tomato looking for a squeeze. No one had ever filled up her diaries. She said, Sherry, I've waited long. Hope it's not too late for you to do me wrong. I want a little amour du jour. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight at 8 o'clock. If you've got the key, it'll fit the lock. I had a very handsome boyfriend once, so big and so strong, but such a dunce. He treated me fair, but he was a square. He knew when, but he didn't know where. I want a little amour du jour. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight, by 9:30, you'll be putting in some overtime. Ladies like men who are big and tall, but I don't mind if you're short and small. I never measure ounce for ounce. After all, honey, it's the punch that counts. I want a little amour du jour. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. Tonight, tonight, by candle glow, my dear, I know your love will grow. I always used to dream of Charles Boyer. I hoped he'd drop in on me someday. Although you have no claim to fame, they tell me with the lights off, it's all the same. I want a little amour du jour. Baby, it's gotta be tonight for sure. We'll be wed, you'll share my bread, and mine'll be thine, and thine'll be mine. All of the time.
And now, news from Washington.
Polish girls arrive at Montreal, Canada, in a post-war labor experiment by a Canadian industrialist. The girls are part of a group of 100 who will work in a rayon mill at Saint-Georges-de-Beauce, where they will receive the Dominion's minimum wage of $12 a week. The displaced girls, brought from Frankfurt, will be taught the rayon spinning process and are under contract for 2 years, during which time they'll be lodged in a convent school. Here they will pay $6.50 of their wages for board and lodging. They, at least, are no longer among Europe's wanderers. On the reverse side, the steamship Radnik waits at Montreal to repatriate 500 Yugoslavs who prefer to try life under Tito. They're not leaving empty-handed. Among them, they have pooled $1 million for the purchase of some rather exclusive commodities. Whether or not life in the Western Hemisphere has been congenial, it is certain that their toil has been rewarded. And so these people return to a native land changed by war and ideology.
But the cry, and nobody's crying but me. Friends all over, no, I'm trying to forget about how much I care for you. It's all over, but the dreaming, poor little that keep trying to come true. It's all over, but the cry. and I can't get over crying over you.
It's all over but the grind,
and nobody's crying but me.
Friends all over know I'm trying
to forget about how much I care for you.
It's all over but the dreaming, poor little dreams that keep trying to come true.
It's all over but the crying,
and I can't get over crying over you.
In my head, feel like old Ned. Hey, what did I do to be so black and blue? No joys for me, no company. Even the mouse seems to run from my house. And all my life through, I've been black and blue. Hey, now I am white, way down deep inside, but baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn. Life is a thorn. Oh, why was I born? What did I do to be so black and blue? But baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face. Lordy, listen to me, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn. Life is a thorn. Oh, why was I born? Hey, what did I do to be so black?
Don't let a bad signal get in the way of the news you need to hear. With the new Elizabeth Radio and its precision tuning technology from Home Electrics, you won't miss that all-too-important news report ever again. The Elizabeth Radio is optimized for the sound frequencies of the human voice, guaranteeing the best sound possible from every newscast. The Elizabeth Radio from Home Electrics, the best in home entertainment for you and your family.
Mad about the boy, I know it's stupid to be mad about the boy. I'm so ashamed of it, but must admit the sleepless nights I've had about the boy. On the silver screen melts my foolish heart in every single scene. Although I'm quite aware that here and there are traces of the cat about the boy. Lord knows I'm not a fool. Lord knows I'm not a schoolgirl in the flurry of her first fair. Will it ever cloy, this odd diversity of misery and joy? I'm feeling quite insane and young again, and all